2.5 hours, an American photojournalist who contracted the Ebola virus while working in West Africa will return to the U.S. for treatment.
He is the fifth American now to get the virus, and he will be the second to be treated at a specialized isolation unit in Omaha, Nebraska. Our Brandy Powell is following this developing story. Brandy.
Yeah, well, Ashoka Mukbo, the fifth American who got Ebola in Liberia, should land in Omaha at about 8:30 this morning. He'll arrive at Epley Airfield, and officials say they're going to keep him away from any public areas of the airport. ABC News has been told Mukbo is in great spirits. We've got a new update as well on that first Ebola patient to be diagnosed in the U.S., Thomas Eric Duncan. You see him right there. He's still in critical condition at a Dallas hospital. And the 50 people who Duncan came into contact with, including his family, well, they are all symptom-free as of right now. The CDC's director says he does not believe Duncan has received any experimental treatments that have been used to treat Ebola in others. Coming up in our next half hour, we'll talk about how Duncan's family is feeling isolated, they say, from the local Liberian community in Dallas. Megan.
Thank you. This afternoon, the head of the CDC will update President Barack Obama on the Ebola outbreak and the administration's response efforts. Officials say that the CDC is getting hundreds of calls and emails every day about Ebola concerns. The World Health Organization says that the virus has killed more than 3,400 people, the majority of them in West Africa.
604 is the time.